to Hagel. Hagel will turn away, play the puck possession game, wait for the change, go to Cole, then get it back. McDavid pulled from behind. That's a penalty taken down by Maroon as well. Probably two penalties, but will likely only get one. McLeod and McDavid going back at Maroon. Of course, Maroon trying to get the coincidental minor now. Edmonton would love this power play at the end of the first here as the players continue to scrum. Chernak in there.
Well, anytime that anyone is near enough to McDavid, there'll be a crowd. Maroon's being somehow steered towards the penalty box. In he goes.
Like an episode of Yellowstone, trying to get the cattle to their proper home. Let's see if it's just the one penalty. You can tell that Kane was in there a lot, but I think they're going to keep it with just the penalty to Maroon, which will give the league's best power play an opportunity late in the first. Here's the call.
Tampa Bay number 14, minor penalty, hooking.
When Evander Kane finds McDavid just prior to this hook and trip of McDavid, McDavid wants to go across to Draisaitl for the one-timer. He delays, goes to his left. That's where all this starts. And the Oiler power play will get the game's first chance. This is not the place Tampa Bay wants to be. Down one, a power play to the Oilers. And it'll be all their big boys on the ice. McDavid and Draisaitl. Hyman gets to the front of the net. Nugent Hopkins is in the bumper spot. And Tyson Barry runs this thing from the point.
Hyman will get to it. Try to get the Oilers set up early.
Now Leon's hammered by to that point.
47th assist for McDavid. That leads the league. He came in tied with Kucherov for the league lead with 46.